Hi, good afternoon. I'm here to talk about the Dead Sea Scrolls. One of the greatest evidences of the Bible. This is one of the greatest ones, even though nowadays there's a lot of evidences in biblical archaeology. And as Jesus said one day, that if his people would be quiet, then the stones would be talking, and the stones are talking. Everywhere are evidence of the Bible and the life of Jesus, and that the God is a great God and is real as much as you and I. As much as I believe that you don't need any evidence to believe in God because it's so real, you need a little teeny tiny faith, a little teeny tiny faith like a mustard seed. But it's good. There are many people. There were never so many people questioning God and the Bible before. So it's a time of information, and everyone has to have access. So I like to share. This is very important. So the Dead Sea Scrolls were found in 1947, long time ago, and still they're just brand new and interesting because that there were 60 there were even if it's more than 60 years ago, they're still studying, people still studying, and took a long time, actually 7 years ago, took a long time for the scholars and the specialists to really define that they are accurate evidence and they are real, but they are. And what happened is that in 1947, two shepherds, they were taking their animals, and the animals get lost. So they went to the caves that in Qumran, in the region of near Wadi Kelt in the desert of Judea, and they start throwing rocks in the caves looking for the animals. And then they heard a noise like breaking something, and they got in and they found the vase, the jars, and there in the ceramic jars there were the manuscripts, these papyrus, and they took them. And there's a long story. I will be putting some links here if you want to research more. I'll put some pictures also. But the most important is there were all the books of the Bible except Esther. So they are great evidence that the Bible is real. If you're questioning, a lot of people say, hey, a lot of people being right in the Bible, so many translations. How the Bible is not the same as would have been written long ago. And it is. It is because about 2,000 years ago, the first Christians, they being persecuted by the emperors, and Nero being killing so many Christians, and they retired to that area. Wadi Qumran near Wadi Kelt in the desert of Judea, and that area it was very dangerous in that time, and they had to be very brave people. But they retired there to survive and write the scriptures. And they made a compilation. They made many, many copies, and this copy is exactly as the disciples wrote, and is exactly like Moses. And the same day from the beginning is the same Bible you and I have today. So you can trust. This is a great evidence. There were 12 caves where they found them. And I'm not here defending religion. I'm here to talk about God, that He is real, because He is the Word. And John says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word became flesh. And the same evidence that Jesus is God between us, it says in the Bible, Emmanuel, the prophecies that were written, hundreds of years before He born, and He is real. So is salvation and heaven and our future with everlasting life with Him. And that is why it's so important. Not just to talking about a historical book, but this is the book that talks about the glory of the Lord and also about salvation for humankind. That's all our hope. So this is very important to know that this book is real. And the manuscripts are great evidence. It's always worth to talk about. See, the Bible is very accurate. One of the curiosities is I rather say that or repeat because I love to say that. The Bible says that the life is in the blood, and life is in the blood. You know, science just proved that, you know. And even though during the whole Middle Age, Renaissance, they've been thinking the earth was flat and fighting about that, the Bible already said that was round, that was a globe. And then Isaiah says that God was over the globe of the earth, you know, and tells us that the earth is a globe. So the Bible says the truth, because as the Bible even says, God is not meant to lie. No, there's no liars in the Bible. There's no liars in the Bible. God's not a liar. Everything he said is true, is real. So if you want a guidance for your life, go find it, you know, from the beginning to the end. As Jesus says, he's at the beginning and he's the end also. He's the Alpha and the Omega. And you're going to find him in his words. He's present in each word of the book. Read it, talk it to him, and he will also talk to you because he loves you. He loves us very much, and that's why he gives us his life. And that's why this book is so important, because it's not just one more book of history of humankind. It's not just a book of philosophy. This is the history of the glory of the Lord, that in the beginning, he created everything perfect and gave us a perfect life, and then we lost it. We were all fully in the glory because of the sin in the world, you know. And then Jesus had to die, so we had another chance. We have a chance to have everlasting life again. And the most important, you know, not just in heaven, not just after this life, but from the moment that you accept Jesus as your Savior, you open your heart and say, I want you to be with me. I want you to be in my heart. I want you to guide me. Forgive my sins. Give me a new life in your presence. Put my name in your book of life. From this moment, you're not just a citizen of heaven. You're not just getting our everlasting eternal life, which is the best thing ever. But also from this moment, you're going to have a more fruitful life in this earth too. And every day you're going to learn. Get your Bible, read, and talk to him. Jesus will talk to you. He is always waiting for you. Okay, he's waiting for all of us. And God is having mercy. And this world is still being ended because God is giving us time to listen. To listen to his word, to learn from him, you know, and you're not just for the moment you, as I said, you receive, you know, you accept Jesus as your Savior and you receive salvation, not just in the heaven, but you also have a much more fruitful life. Every day you're gonna live better because you live for purpose. And you know, in the beginning, the glory of the Lord was taken. We were falling and we couldn't get close to God. And then the temple had a big curtain and nobody could get close to God. If you touch the ark, they would die, you know. But, you know, when Jesus gave his life to die on the cross, the curtain of the temple tore. Was, you know, from top to the bottom, the curtain was split in parts. Because there's no separation between us and God anymore. We're his children. We can be in his presence anytime through Jesus. Now you can talk to God anytime. Jesus Christ is, you know, is knocking the door every day. And he wants us. He wants us so much, you know, and so easy. Just open the heart, talk to him, and ask him to be our Savior, our Lord, and guide us to a fruitful life and everlasting life in eternity. Thank you very much for listening. A wonderful afternoon, and God bless you all. Thank you.